Hello everyone, welcome back to LWC course series, and this is day 13 episode where we are going to talk and discuss about one of the LWC error messages which we generally see in our development. And many times, even in the interview, you may be asked about this error. So let's talk about this, you know, error and understand so that in future, if you experience this error, or you know, I mean, in your future interviews, you should be able to answer them and rectify this error very efficiently. I will show you, you know, I mean, the error, how you know, I mean, the error looks like, or how this error appears, so that you know, I mean, as soon as you can see this error and the message, you will immediately you should have the answer that why this error is occurring, and then you can start working on the troubleshooting and rectifying. So let's say if your component is already available on record detail page or any other place, then you will see the error message, something like, you know, I mean the, or not something like, or, you know, I mean the, you will see 100%, you will see this message as cannot read properties of null reading. Now this can be different, okay? Because that is something, you know, I mean the, you are using in your code, but the error message cannot read properties of null reading, and the whatever, you know, I mean the, you are trying to access that the name, you know, I mean that particular element name you will see here, okay? Okay, let's say, you know, I mean you are trying to add the component using the app builder. And you know, I mean the generally, like, you know, I mean the, I added the component here in the detail page. So if you're trying to add the, you know, I mean the component using the app builder, and that time you know, I mean you experience this error, so the one extra, you know, I mean the line you will see in this error, otherwise, you know, I mean the rest of the things you will, you know, it's exactly the same. See here, okay, what is this line means? Actually, this line is very important to, you know, I mean, and makes our job easy to, you know, I mean, the understand that what's the root cause of the error. So if you read this, error during LWC component, okay, constructor phase. Which phase? Constructor phase. So you remember in the, you know, I mean, the previous episodes, we talked about the life cycle hooks. Okay, and in that, you know, I mean, we discussed in detail about the constructor. So from, you know, I mean, the root cause or the place from this, from where this error is coming is actually the constructor. Okay, now inside this constructor of which component? Of this component. Okay, this is the component name. I will show you, you know, the code as well, but I'm just trying to, first of all, make you understand that, you know, how you read this error message and then get straight away to the root cause. Okay, so this is the component of this component, lifecycle hook constructor. Okay, and inside this, you know, I mean the constructor, you are trying to read this particular, you know, I mean the property or element. Okay, so you understood, okay, that where exactly, you know, I mean, is the root cause. Let me show you the code as well. So, you know, I mean, the, this is, you know, I mean, the learn LWC. This is one of, you know, I mean, the component I have. And I am treating this as a child component. So in this child component, you know, I mean, the, I am, you know, I have created one of, you know, I mean, the property with the name as child prop, which, you know, I mean, you see the name here, okay? But this is not the, you know, I mean, but this is not the, you know, I mean, the place from where the error message is coming. Error message is coming from parent component, okay? So let's go into the parent component. So as I said, the parent component, constructor phase. So the parent component, constructor phase, okay? And inside the, you know, I mean, this constructor phase, this child property is actually you are trying to access, okay? You're trying to read, okay? You're trying to access. So, you know, I mean, when you're trying to access, you are getting the error, okay? Now, let us understand. let us understand, why this error. So basically, this error cannot read properties of null reading is a JavaScript error. Okay. And to demonstrate this thing to you, I have created one HTML page, which is also, they have a small piece of a JavaScript code, and will be, sufficient enough to explain you that why this error message is coming, or what are the root causes, or what are the, the reasons behind when you see this error message. Okay. So this is, the HTML page with the name as null error. If you want, I can put it, put the code in the GitHub repository for you so that you can use it. Okay. And the GitHub repository link I will share in the, the video's description. Okay. So this is the error, the null error HTML page name. Inside this, you can see there is an element we have, that is for the input, okay? And the ID is my input, okay? This one. Okay? Now, if I reload this page, see, without any error, it is reloading, okay? Without any error. See the console log as well, right? Now, you see in the this is the script, okay? So what, when we have to write the JavaScript, this is also, one of the way by which, using the script tags, we can put our JavaScript and can use in the HTML, okay? Now, inside, this script tag, what I'm trying to do, I am trying to access the element which is with the ID my input. Okay, see here, line number 7, there's an element input element, and the ID is my input, and I'm trying to access it, right? So let's say if I make sorry, let's say I comment this element, which means now this, the element is not available. But you see here at line number 13, I am still accessing the, the my input, okay, element with my input, but actually it's not available. So let me refresh this. And you see the element is not available here, okay? And you are getting an error here. If I copy this error, see here. See here. Okay. So the one thing, the one possible reason whenever you experience this error in the LWC. So one of the possible reason is the element which you are trying to access is actually not available. Let me, the write the reasons. That DOM element not found or available. Okay. Second, trying to access property of an object before it is populated by fetching or asynchronous call. Okay. Two reasons. One, either the element which you are trying to access is not available, or maybe due because of the asynchronous call, you have actually the try to access, but it's still it is available but hasn't been rendered. Okay. It is available, but it's not, the being available on UI. Okay. So rendering, is taking time, but you are accessing, accessing the element, or the property of an object. So that is also the one of the reason, right? Okay. So you understood? Okay. So how you will reach to the root cause of the error, and what is, the possible, possible way. Now, let me do one thing. Let me show you. So let's say, I'm in the, I am. What I did here is I added a button. Okay, so instead of the accessing the child components property inside the constructor, I added a button, and you see here this is a button. Okay, and on click, we have a handle click method. Now inside, the handle click method, I am going to access this child components property, which is child prop. Okay. So deployed, okay, fair enough. Control Shift R. Okay, this time no error, okay. See, no error, okay, and because we have the console log here, okay. So let me open the console log. One second. One second. So this is working fine. Okay. And let me show you one thing. So if I go here and let's say if I, make it as structure. Deploy. Okay, so this error message is, I'm in the populating again if I revert back my changes. Okay. So this is all about, the today's the day 13 episode. In the next episode, I am going to talk about the next error, but till then revise your the concepts. And in case if you have any doubt, any problem, please let me know in the comment section. And then please give a thumbs up, hit a like button, and share your experience in the comment section, and appreciate my hard work. Thank you. We'll meet again in day 14. Till then, take care. Jai Hind.